Hey, this is Jessie with theprepared.com, and today we're going to study a very valuable skill called triangulation. It's what you use when you're lost. You're not quite sure where you are anymore. So first thing I'm going to do is find an area with good visibility where I can see the natural features around me and really get a good pick on them. Then I find a flat level spot where I can lay out my map and orient it to the landscape. So here I oriented it to true north, and then I found a fist-sized distance, and that becomes my general location. I say, okay, I know I'm somewhere within this area. Now I just want to pinpoint that. So now I'm going to look for other features outside that fist-sized distance that'll help me take a bearing and figure out exactly where I am. So let's stand on up for a sec. So I've already looked around a little bit, and I figured out that this is Niwot Hill, or Niwot Mountain, and I identified the roundness of the peak there. It's got another peak beyond it. It has a long ridge line that comes down and then swerves toward me. So once I correctly identify it, and I am positive that that mountain is the mountain on my map, I know where it is, I'm going to go ahead and point the direction of travel arrow directly at the top of Niwot Mountain, and I'm going to rotate the shed until it fits right around Red Fred. And once I do that and it's right in place, I take this then down to the map and I put the edge of my compass on Niwot Mountain. And I orient the back now, you see it's a little bit off. I'm gonna orient that, move it, until Fred is back directly in that shed. And when he is, I'm gonna draw a line from Niwot Mountain right along that bearing that I got. So I continue, sweet, keep going. I go all the way through where I think my general location is. And that's my first angulation. Now I'm gonna do that with a second peak. I noticed Burnt Mountain was about 60 degrees or so off of Niwot. I want something that's 60 to 120 degrees off of each other. So I could end up with something that looks like an equilateral triangle. So my direction of travel arrow was pointed at Burnt Mountain. Rotate the shed till it fits neatly around Fred again. Sweet, looks like right about there. And now I'm gonna come down to the map again. Put the tip of my compass on Burnt Mountain. Rotate the back. Oh, which way have I got to go there? Look out for the pencil. Got some magnetics. Rotate it till they're right in place again, and I draw another line. That was a little closer, so that goes faster. Now I'm going to do that with a third point. Found another peak out here on the horizon. Same thing. Point the front of my compass, that direction of travel arrow at it. Move the shed to meet Fred. Get a bearing of about 32. Come on down to the map. Put the tip of my compass on that point, just like so. Give you some shade so you can see a little better. And rotate this back. Looks like I need to move it this way until Red Fred is back in that shed. Everybody's lined up. Awesome. And I'm going to draw another line. Come in here. Orient it. Good. Come on through. Right there. Sweet. So now I have a place where all three lines intersect. I've got here, here, and here coming in. So it's gotten me really pinpointed. Usually you want at least the size of your pinky. And now I can just look at my local features and say, yep, that's where I am. Mission accomplished.